Hi everyone, this is Anson from AnsonAlex.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can use Google Trends to find out what people are searching for online. Google Trends is a tool by Google that allows us to see statistics related to what people are searching for. It's great for researching current events, doing SEO research, or just finding out what people are interested in. And if you ask me, will this ever replace keyword research tools for bloggers and journalists? I absolutely think it will. There's been some big updates. Let's go ahead and let's take a look. Okay, so here I am at trends.google.com, and you'll notice that right from the get-go here on Google Trends, we can just start searching. Now, I'm not going to do that quite yet because I want to go through this homepage a little bit and show you where things are located, but we will do that later on in the video, and I can tell you that it's a lot more powerful than it used to be when Google Trends first came out. So, first of all, I want to mention that in the top left of Google Trends, we have these three lines, and this is where we can navigate throughout Google Trends. From the homepage, we can actually just scroll down to these sections, which we're going to do, but if you ever end up on the Explore page or the Trending Searches page, and you need to get back to the homepage or another one of these pages, you can do so with the left navigation over here. Now, below the search box, we have some search terms that Google has provided us with as an example. These are popular searches, so you can see Taylor Swift, Kim Kardashian, World Cup, football, American football. So these are just examples, but let's click on one of these examples to take a look at the type of information we can find here in Google Trends. So if I click on World Cup, you'll notice that we're brought to this screen that tells us all about this World Cup search term. And at the top, we can specify what date range we want to look at data for. So right now we're only looking at the past 7 days, but you'll notice that you have a number of different options in there, including 2004 to present. We could do 30 days, see how that changes. You can see that the interest has gone up quite a bit in 30 days. And we could search for a particular category. Now I find this is a little interesting because a lot of the time, you know, your search term is kind of your category, so you don't always need to use this, but there may be certain situations where it could be helpful. So you do have that category drop down as well. And then you can choose, do you want to look at when people are searching the web or when they're searching images or news or Google Shopping or even YouTube? So you can see for those of you who are doing SEO research, this can be really helpful. You can look at just YouTube videos. So for a content creator like me on YouTube, you know, that's going to be very useful. Now, I want to mention that this is very important. When we look at this graph and we see 55 here, obviously, that is not the number of queries that World Cup had on August 18th. There were way more than 55 queries for World Cup on August 18th. This is how it compares to other days. And if we actually click on this question mark here at interest over time, you'll notice that it tells us a number that is relative to the highest point on the chart for a given region in time. So a 100 is peak popularity, and a value of 50 means it's about half as popular. So it's been more popular before. So you'll notice that when we're looking at this World Cup chart, we're going all above the 50s here. So this is more popular than it usually is. Now, if we were to change our time frame to 2004 to present, let's see how, hey, what do you know? It seems like it's getting really popular every 4 years or so. I wonder why that would be. So obviously, you know, for the World Cup, that's actually a really cool example. I didn't even realize that before showing you, but you can see how it gets a lot more popular every 4 years for the World Cup. Now, when we're looking at a search term, we can also scroll down and see the interest by region. And again, these are relative numbers. So basically saying that for our date range, which is now, I think, 2014 to present, Nepal is where there is the, you know, highest percentage of search queries related to World Cup, right? Argentina's up there, Panama, Lebanon, Uruguay. So, you know, that might be interesting if you're producing content for the World Cup. You might want to try and target some of your users who are in Nepal a little bit more, maybe Argentina. So you can find out a lot of information like that. And now we can also see related queries. So like I said, we have a huge date range now. So we're seeing things from the last, you know, 20 years or so. So a lot of things from 2018. But if we go back up and we were to change that to, say, the past day, now we can maybe find some really breakout terms. So here you go. So these terms are up, you know, 1,300%, this term 800% for the equator there, Chile national football team up 450%. So reporting on current events, things happening right now, you can see how Google Trends is invaluable. Now, I do want to mention, this is probably a good spot to do this. If you are a World Cup journalist, I want to show you how you can set up some subscriptions so you can get notified and updates on trends within your industry. So what we can do is we can go over here to the left of Google Trends and click on the three lines, and we can go down to this subscriptions section. You'll notice that it says we have no subscriptions. but we can add subscriptions by clicking on the plus icon. So we're going to go to the bottom right and click on the plus icon, and now we can add subscriptions. So we can add a topic here and then select our region and then how often we'd like to receive an update, either once a week or once a month. We can also look at trending searches. So this would be more general. So you can choose which type of daily search trends you'd like to see, top daily search trends, the majority, or just all of them. It's not going to be every single one, but it's going to be the top, you know, a big list of them. And then how often? Do you want it throughout the day, once a day, or once a week? I like to subscribe to particular topics. So like I said, if we were a World Cup journalist, you know, we could just enter in World Cup and choose this search term. We can say we want the worldwide region and we want an update about once a week. And so then we could go ahead and click on subscribe. And now we will get an email with the trending searches related to this search term and just how it's performing overall. Okay, so let's go back to the homepage. So, you know, this is where we started and we clicked on World Cup, and I wanted to scroll down a little bit to show you some more areas here within Google Trends. So you'll notice that we have this latest stories and insights section, and this is actually pretty cool. We can click on show more and we can see more of the latest stories. These are some of the most popular topics on the internet right now. And then for each one of them, we can actually click on them and it brings up a page related to this particular topic. So we've got the 2022 NBA Finals. So obviously there's some featured insights and you've got the Boston Celtics and the Golden State Warriors right at the top, the two teams that played in the finals. So that makes sense. And you've got some other teams that got close, right? So you've got the Heat and Dallas were also trending at that time as well. But as we scroll down further, we find even more information. So we can see where the search interest was within the past day for different teams. You can see Boston's got the Northeast, and then it looks like Golden State is more popular in the rest of the country, except for Montana, interestingly enough. So you can see which players are being searched for. Steph Curry, number one, Klay Thompson, Tatum, Poole, Draymond Green. And as you scroll down, we can see some of the top queries that are trending related to the NBA Finals. So again, if you're a sports reporter, you know, you could start, you know, looking in here and you could go to the top 20 queries. You could look through and see if there's anything that you could report on as a story. And this page just kind of keeps going on and on. There's some of the top questions that people are asking during the regular season. Who's the tallest player? Who has the most points? So it's a good idea to take a look at the top stories and then come in, dig a little deeper, and find out if there's anything that you can report on. Let's go back to the homepage. So moving on down here on the homepage, we also have this section called Year in Search, and this is a really cool feature. And I'm going to click on, let's go back to 2018. Let's skip, we're not gonna get close to 2020, okay? Let's go back before 2020, and let's see what people were searching for. So you can see that we have the top searches, but then we also have top searches broken down by categories. So we have the top news search, the top people, athletes, actors, and it goes on and on. And this can be used in a number of different ways. This can obviously be used for history pieces. So if you're doing a piece, you know, about a certain time in history, you could find out what was popular during that year by coming in here to Google Trends. If you came to this page right after 2018 ended and you looked at these fashion searches over here on the right, you could say, maybe I should start incorporating some 1980s styles into my fashion. That seems to be popular right now. If you are a food blogger, you could take a look at the food section and you could say, I should come up with a unicorn cake recipe because, you know, that was popular in 2018. Obviously, you know, this would be better if you were looking, like I said, right at the beginning of 2019. I just wanted to look at a year that wasn't quite so close to us right now so that we could be a little bit more casual about what we're seeing in these search results. And you can see the list goes on and on. We've got sports teams, politicians, weddings that people are searching about. So again, really good place to get content ideas. So at this point, we've gone through everything here on the homepage in Google Trends, and I've showed you how to use subscriptions. The next step is for you to just start searching terms that you're interested in. So, you know, if you have a cooking website, you could, you know, search for dinner recipes. And you enter that search term, click enter, and then you can specify, you know, what you want your date range to be, all of that sort of thing, where people are searching from. But what I'm really interested in is this related queries. Ooh, right now it looks like people are breaking out looking for some quinoa recipes. So there you go. Great idea. You can do a lot of different things with quinoa. Go ahead and come up with a new recipe that incorporates quinoa, get it in the title, and you've got a chance to maybe get a little bit of extra traffic today. If I were to click on this query right here, we'll see the specifics for this query. We can see where people are searching, California. And then, you know, if there were related queries, we would see that as well. So you can see people are also looking for vegan recipes, related topics. People are looking on how to cook in a slow cooker, instant pots, looking how to cook pasta, plant potatoes, There's all sorts of things you can find here in Google Trends. So hopefully after watching this tutorial, you're a little bit more comfortable in navigating throughout Google Trends and knowing what you can find. Because now that I've showed you some examples, you should be able to take some keywords from your industry and apply them here in Google Trends and get a step up on the competition by gaining some insight into what people are looking for right now. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. And if you want to see more technology tips and tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I have for you for now. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.